Good morning, people.
Wake up, Doc.
Is there a doctor in the house?
Where's that?
Give it to me straight, Doc.
Give it to me straight, Doc.
Well, you know what they say. An apple a day keeps the doctor away.
Yes.
Nobody says a candy bar a day keeps the doctor away.
Attention.
Turn your head and call.
Gotta wait for it. Here it comes. Wait till the end.
It's showtime.
There we go right there. You know, on the road, I can't believe how many times I heard that song on radio stations.
And you think of our time together here.
Yeah, it's funny because before he made that into a bumper,
yeah,
I rarely ever heard the song anymore.
And now you hear it.
Now
it's because of us.
Everywhere.
Our loyal fans are asking for it.
It's kind of like when you buy that car.
Mm-hmm.
And now that you own that car, you notice everybody else has got the same car as you, but you never noticed it before. Well, let's go ahead and get into the round table here made possible by St. John's Place of Fordyce, Ouachita Nursing and Rehab in Camden is the choice for all your rehabilitation and long-term care needs. They provide award-winning short-term therapy services as well. Reach St. John's Place by calling 870-352-2104. Or online at stjohnsplaceofarkansas.com and Ouachita Nursing and Rehab by calling 870-836-4111 or online at ouachitanursing.com. And then, of course, First Choice Family Care, 476 Hospital Drive here in Camden, 870-800-9002. Now open 7 to 7 for all your medical needs. Dr. Smith, who's here in the studio with us.
Good morning.
And her staff, who's not in the studio with us, strive to make every patient feel at home, and they have just one goal in mind, and that's a healthier you. So go to myfirstchoicecare.com for a new patient packet, and then call 870-800-9006 to follow up. And then OCMC's Chemical Dependency Unit, they'd like to remind you that you're not alone. Addiction is a tough thing to get past, so make the choice to be a better you. Call 870-836-1289 or 800-232-1289. All calls are confidential. Michelot's Body Shop, auto body collision repair, framework, glasswork, and refinishing. Accidents happen, so if you put it in the ditch, you better call Maria at 837-2560. Everybody's Antiques in El Dorado, corner of Bradley and West Hillsboro, has 120 booths and 31,000 square feet to explore. Shop them online at everybodysantiques.com or call 870-875-1444. I highly recommend you just go there and go walk around. Bring a friend. You might get lost. Story's Floor and Carpet, 2004 Lorraine in El Dorado, does more than just flooring. They do custom tile backsplashes, countertops, bathrooms, and more. You're invited to visualize your new flooring projects online at storiesfloor.com. Upload your photo into their room visualize, and see your options. 870-862-9446. You know, it's just not the same when I have to do it solo. It's just not.
You were in such a good flow, I didn't want to interrupt you.
Oh, well. I mean, you know, we're just here hanging out. So, I mean, you're more than welcome to interject anytime.
Well, how do people get a hold of us if they wanted to call in or...
And, like, ask a question?
Yeah.
836-9559.
That's a lifeline, right?
Yeah. Is this like a pop quiz?
Yeah.
Because I'm ready for it. Let's
yeah.
Go.
What's
yeah,
that text line?
All right.
But we don't text and drive.
No, we don't want to text and drive.
Don't be on your phone and drive. That's dumb. Don't make dumb choices.
Well, what if you've got a wireless headset or something like that?
Well, that's different.
Okay. All right.
And I can ask Google to, like, do things for me, too.
Google, call a radio station.
Don't tell it that. It will.
I found out that's why they do the thing where they say you can listen to us on, like, Alexa and Google and all that.
Yeah.
And then they say, just say, hey, Alexa. And then they say whatever it is. And then if you've got Alexa in your room near the radio, it'll
yeah.
activate Alexa to go do it.
Oh. Well, cool.
It's a little trick they use. But yes, the text line is 501-313-0944.
And they can be on social media?
I don't have it running at the moment.
I know.
So, well, I have it recording in the background, and then I'm going to post it later.
Okay. Well,
yeah.
It's hard to be two places at once.
It is. So,
right,
and not only that, though, I got to pull the podcast out of it, too. See?
Oh, yeah. Well, we got it.
Which will also be available online and later
yeah.
today.
Perfect.
So, right now, though, we just got Y95 and KBEU.
And all of our loyal listeners, right?
And the stream. People can listen on the stream, too.
Oh, okay. Well, see, we got all this playing. So if you guys don't have questions, we've got stuff.
What kind of stuff we got?
So tomorrow is World AIDS Day.
So everybody's getting AIDS.
What I like to think is that you guys can all go get free testing at Future Builders. And you can get tested twice a year, and you get a gift card for getting tested.
Yeah, that's how they conned me into it.
And I'll tell you that I know Robin Thrower, who's over there, and she is doing a fantastic job. And even discussing with her work in the area, she talked about, we realize, like, as a medical professional, that we kind of have prejudices when it comes to sexually transmitted infection. You know, you kind of think, oh, well, it couldn't be someone that looks like me, you know, and she's had that experience as well, that having somebody come positive that she would not have anticipated been positive. And it ends up, it was one little dalliance from outside of a marriage. And so it was a young woman with young kids and ended up testing positive for HIV.
So it's not people that look hideous and
right, or do drugs, or prison.
The stereotypical things you would think associated with bad behavior.
Right.
It can be good people.
It can be good, normal, everyday people.
Good-looking people.
Yeah.
And then next thing you know, bam.
And the bit most important thing is just knowing. Because now there are so many treatment options. We can get your viral counts down to zero, and it never has to progress to AIDS. Because HIV is a virus. We have treatments for that virus. And at the end stage, we call that AIDS. And so it doesn't have to get to that end stage anymore. People don't have to die of HIV.
Yeah, a lot of people kind of confuse that. They think it's all the one and the same.
Right.
So you can be HIV positive, but not have AIDS.
AIDS is a certain point in the development of that virus.
Right.
And so if you keep that virus suppressed, you don't get into the AIDS category.
And that's the bad part.
That's the bad part.
Okay.
That's when you kind of have a number floating over your head as to how long you have left.
So the HIV's not so bad.
No, it's very treatable. But the key thing is that it is a very, don't want to say intelligent, because there's discussion as to whether or not viruses are even alive, because technically they don't have their own cells. They just invade other cells. And so,
hey, I'm coming in.
I think they're aliens. There's no other thing like them. But that particular virus is very elegantly designed, maybe. I don't know how to. It'll mutate very quickly. It can progress very rapidly. And so the biggest thing is just getting identified so that you can get treatment, because treatment can keep your levels down to zero, and then you're not passing it to other people.
Yeah, see, I keep seeing these ads in my news feed. I don't know why they showed up all the time. I haven't been researching or anything, and I haven't really talked about it. But now I'm getting these ads for these pharmaceutical drugs that, you know, the guy saying...
For HIV?
Well, yeah, it's like a guy is saying, you know, I'm undetectable. Be undetectable. And, you know, talking about being, you know, if they get tested, they don't detect anything.
Right. Because you can suppress that infection so much that you don't, your viral load is zero. And so you can't pass a virus that is not present.
Right.
So if everyone went out and got tested, we could identify those few people that are positive, get them down to zero, and now we can eradicate HIV.
And if you get the bad news, hey, here's a Walmart gift card.
Even if you get the good news. But
well, mine was good news, and I got a $25 gift card. I mean, I couldn't turn down $25.
And you can do it twice a year. You can get gas with that gift card.
Yeah, I know. And I tried to do it again, and they got me on that list. And they're like, no, you can't do it again.
6 months.
Yeah.
But, I mean, a gas card is a gas card.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just a finger stick. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's super quick. It's right there. And then you would need confirmatory testing. But Robin's really great at getting all that set up. And so making sure that you know is the biggest thing, because like that young mother, the person that gave it to her probably didn't know that they had it, but it's made her life much more complicated now, even though she wasn't really at risk, per se.
Mm-hmm.
And the people that are at highest risk, that's the other thing that a lot of people don't know about, is that there are different ways to do that that can help keep you from getting it if you are at higher risk. So, for example, men who have sex with men, that's the highest risk group. And there's medicine that you can take before an encounter, like prophylactically, and then medicine you can take after an encounter.
Yes, because I notice all the people in these ads, they're all guys.
Well, I think it's probably lending towards that group, and it's probably you're probably seeing it more with the World AIDS Day coming up.
Maybe that's why I keep because it just happened this week.
Yeah, so I think it's anticipation.
I thought that was kind of weird.
Kind of a coordinated effort trying to discuss HIV.
I was like, does social media know something about me? I don't know.
So HIV is no longer a death sentence, or it doesn't have to be. But the key thing is that it can be if you don't know. And if you don't know, it you can give that death sentence to someone else who now has it and doesn't know.
Mm-hmm.
So it's no longer, it's only a death sentence if you don't get treated.
Right.
It's not something that, maybe I'll be fine. You will not.
Yeah, and I guess once you start showing the signs, it's too late?
It's not too late, but early signs of HIV can be really complicated to catch. A lot of people will kind of miss those earlier signs because it is a virus. And so what, you have kind of achy, you know, it can be vague symptoms in a viral prodrome. And unfortunately, what happens right before you get sick with this virus can look like a lot of other viruses.
Yes, because when we first learned about AIDS, I was in seventh grade and they were talking to us about it. And they like gave us a list of all these symptoms to be looking for.
And you're like, I felt that yesterday.
Yeah, because they were talking about like when you're asleep.
I have AIDS.
And you wake up because you're hot. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have AIDS. So you got a room full of seventh graders that are in panic mode now because something on that list is matched.
Yeah, we've got to, I really believe in giving kids honest information, not hiding things because they're young, but it has to be age appropriate as well. And so that conversation probably could have been different.
Well, and considering this was back in the, so it had to be 85 when I was in seventh grade. So 1985, the knowledge about AIDS and what they knew about
it was scary.
Yeah, it was like
just scary.
It was to the point that you could, you know, the fear was you could touch something and you got AIDS, or you could be around somebody, you got AIDS, and as bad as we feared COVID. You know, I mean, you just walk into a room, poof, you got the AIDS.
Right, and I would argue that there was more kind of limited understanding of viral syndromes and the HIV virus, because when AIDS first started, they didn't really catch it till they're finding men that have sex with men who are dying of this weird thing, and they would have like multiple weird infections that they never see, like respiratory. There's certain bacteria that if you test positive on that swab, I'm checking you for HIV. Mm-hmm. Because and I've seen it myself in training where young man that was hospitalized, when the cultures came back, we checked for HIV, and it was HIV. And so those secondary infections that can happen when your immune system is compromised can be very characteristic. But with those things that can happen, those had all happened because we didn't know to look for them back then. And so you were seeing end-stage AIDS by the time you identify that there's something wrong with this person. And then you confound that with the stigma of being gay at that time, that it was mainly happening to gay men. It just made it so much worse. You know, the idea that they were somehow different from everybody else already and less than, or, you know, people were very judgmental and still are, to be honest. But to complicate that with the fact that you have this unknown infection that we don't know how you get it, and you end up dying from it, and you get these really weird, like, you can get different really aggressive skin cancers, and like there, so you can get disfiguring rashes And that's what you're seeing is it's almost like leprosy. You mm-hmm. can imagine that it's like unclean and you were already gay to begin with. It's like, it's a double whammy. Like people already judged you and stayed away from you and had personal thoughts about your lifestyle choices. And then now you physically are disfigured, you know, and then you die. You know, that's what happened to Freddie Mercury.
Yeah.
And so, but now we can catch it much sooner and it's not the same. And I would argue that please having different sexual preferences is your own business and no one else's. But if you ever engage in, you know, warm, spicy things as a man with other men, you should get tested once a year. Just a little spicy. You know, you might not go full spice, but any kind of spice. If you enjoy activities, even if it's clandestine activities,
mm-hmm.
please get tested once a year. Like, as a physician, the people that spread it are people that do have preferences that kind of go both ways frequently, and then...
Well, what if you're just a straight shooter and, you know, I mean, you're very active and, best way of putting it, just being very active, I mean, shouldn't you still?
That young mother, she was a straight shooter.
Yeah.
She was in a married relationship.
So, yeah, I mean, it doesn't matter whether you like the paprika, you know, add a little dash of salt there with it, or if you're the straight shooter. I mean, if you're active is active, right?
Active is active. But if that partner had known that, hey, I'm higher risk because I'm having other sexual endeavors with other people, I'm going to get tested once a year. Great. Then we might have got caught that, and then we could have prophylaxed the person that you know that you're sleeping with regularly.
Oh, gosh. That means you have to go back and figure out everyone you've been with. And then you got to go tell them, right?
Right. And the other thing that a lot of people don't realize is that it is a felony.
I was about to ask.
To disclose your medical information. So your physician will not disclose your medical information. That fear of people finding out you want testing for HIV should not keep you from being tested. Because none of that will get out. Now the health department will step in and work with you to try to identify people that are at risk.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not like somebody's like, oh, Johnny's in here getting tested for HIV. You know, no one's going to do that. It's a felony. I'm not going to prison for you.
So the nurse is not going to walk into the lobby and be like, all right, whoever's here for the HIV testing.
Come on up. You made bad choices. Get back here.
We didn't say your name.
Yeah, gosh.
Three people stand up.
Yeah. But you can go to Future Builders and have a very private consultation and have that immediate test and know that you're not at risk. And if you are at increased risk, if you have lots of sexual partners, especially like unexpected ones that just kind of maybe singular events with multiple people.
Just kind of happened, one of those kind of things. It's like, you know, mind my own business.
Not my business, but if that's your business, you can get tested at
Future Builders. Just get in here at the bus stop and things happen.
My favorite quote on love is that love is like a fire. You never know if it's going to warm your hearth or burn down your house.
Yes.
And that's kind of how I feel about how I talk to even like young people about sexual encounters and birth control and things, is like, you can have the best of intentions and then all of a sudden the fire burns down the house.
Yeah.
And so if you're feeling warm, fuzzy feelings, you should probably just plan for that.
I really like the smell of the candle, but it took the house with it.
Exactly.
It went from smelling like, you know, pine needles to a burnt house.
Yeah. And so that it's like you don't always plan for encounters like that. So I've heard all kinds of people, well, I'm not in a relationship right now. It's like, that might change tomorrow.
Things happen.
Like that fire, you never know if it's just going to be a warm hearth or rubble. The house is going to be in rubble.
Everything's in coals now.
And so a lot of people make the mistake too of thinking that, oh, well, one of us is on birth control, some sort of contraception, it's fine. And it's like, actually, no, birth control protects from sexually transmitted infection. Only barrier contraception, which is like condoms. So.
Yeah, but, you know, George Bush, Bush 43, came out, they were talking about HPV. It was back when they were actually starting to push the vaccines and everything.
Right.
And Bush 43 was talking about even using condoms.
Yeah.
Doesn't protect all the way from HPV.
It doesn't protect completely from any STI. And there's ways that people use condoms that make them less effective. So if you have any kind of penetrating intercourse and then you take off, then you put on a condom, well, that's not protecting you.
That defeated the whole purpose right
yes,
there.
Yes, exactly.
But supposedly it had to be with the way that you apply the application, if you will. And if you do not properly apply, that there could be some slippage.
There's that. And then also there's parts that still touch or are really close that doesn't cover.
Yes. That's right? What he was talking about.
That could be really uncomfortable if you had something that covered like the whole.
But supposedly that's how you could still get the HPV, even though you're doing the right things and stuff.
And that's going to be any STD. That's not just HIV or HPV. That's syphilis, which is, I've diagnosed more syphilis than I ever thought I ever would. I thought it was like a historical thing, like we learn about the plague and like things, you know, and what happened. And so I thought when we were learning about syphilis, it's like, oh, this happened like back in like the Middle Ages in France or whatever, right?
Yeah, like Napoleon dying from syphilis.
Or Al Capone, even. That's the most recent thing I can think of, right? It's old school. We got rid of that.
Yeah. Like the chicken pox and TB, right? Yeah.
So that's not true. It's back on the rise. So, and I've diagnosed at least 3 or 4 people with it. And I'd love to tell you that they're like really deranged people, but they're all young, fairly good-looking people.
Yeah, see, when I first moved here back 7 years ago, my friends in El Dorado were telling me, oh, stay away, don't do anything in Ouachita County. It's the capital.
El Dorado ain't any better.
And then I have people in here going, oh, don't go to Union County. That's the capital of all these things.
You can actually look at all these statistics at the Arkansas Department of Health website. So if you'd like to know who stands up to who, there's science behind that, yeah, and
see,
it's available.
You know, I'm just going to go to Union County for Whataburger, see, and that's fine with me.
I like off the rail. Off the rail.
Off the rail?
Yeah.
Well, I haven't heard of that.
Oh, it's down by the square.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. I'll have to go play down the square.
Yeah, it's good stuff. But
I won't catch the SIF if I just do that, though.
No, uh-uh. If you just stick to good food.
Won't have a Hep C and a smile.
So, yeah, tomorrow is World HIV Day, and you should go get tested.
Just for the sake of it.
For.
Then you get a Walmart gift card.
Yeah. Yeah.
They gave me a lanyard.
That's fun.
Yeah, which had the HIV stuff all over it. And I'm thinking, yeah.
I'm going to wear this around.
And it's got on there about testing and everything. And I'm like, yeah, that's it.
Yeah,
That's what I'm going to wear to Walmart when I'm using my Walmart gift card. Yeah. So it stays in the house and it hangs keys that aren't used every day.
Oh, that's nice.
So I found a use for it.
Yeah, that's good. You know, coming up this next week is flu vaccination week.
Oh, we're doing the flus now?
And I don't really understand why they put it this late in the year, because
they
recommend getting it in October.
Yeah.
But this coming week is going to be National Influenza Vaccination Week.
So do you get a gift card with your flu shot?
I don't think you get a gift card with the flu shot.
See, now I don't want to go get a flu shot.
But I can tell you in the U.S., just since October, so this is from October 1st to November 18th is what this data is from, and this is U.S. data, so national, there have been 1.2 to 2.6 million flu cases.
Jeez.
Yeah. And that has resulted in between 500,000 and 1.2 million office visits. So copays, that kind of, but between 15,000 to 30,000 hospitalizations. So now we're not only inconvenienced by having to go to the doctor, but you're staying overnight at the hospital due to flu. And there have been estimated between 1 and 2,000 deaths from the flu this season.
Is that a certain age group, or is that just anybody who just has complications overall?
That's data from overall. I don't. So when you look at Arkansas data, I have more access to that, that I trust. And so in Arkansas, There have been 4 people that have died from the flu in Arkansas since October 1st.
Jeez.
Yeah. And since January 1st in Arkansas, there have been 584 people die of COVID.
Which number is greater?
584.
Which one was... No, I mean, which one was greater, the flu or the COVID? Because that number is just kind of jumbled in my head there.
So, flu is just since October, there's been 4.
Mm-hmm.
COVID, there have been 580 since January.
So, COVID's still the king.
It is still killing a lot of people. And that's why you can go get a booster. You don't have to get COVID. Like, and if you still get COVID after your booster, you're much less likely to be hospitalized. You're much less likely to die. Like, the statistics on COVID vaccination and death from COVID makes it very obvious that people that get vaccinated, even if you still get COVID, it's much less severe unless you have, like, an immune-compromised condition. And with that, you still want the protection that you could get, whatever you could get from the vaccine. But it just may not be as effective as people with an intact immune system.
All right.
But in influenza-related hospitalization and death, and again, all this data is just Arkansas, and it's just since October the 1st. So, since October the 1st, kids under the age of 4, there have been 144 cases and 6 hospitalized. So, that's your baby in the hospital due to flu.
Mm-hmm.
That's not fun. That's little babies. There's been 256, like, school age and 8 hospitalized. In the 18 to 24 group, 53 and 3 hospitalized. 25 to 44 years old, 160 cases. So that school age group and then their parents and 8 hospitalized.
Well, that's because the kids brought it home from school and then gave it to
exactly.
the whole family.
And then the 45 to 64, so just under Medicare, 104 cases, 9 hospitalized. And when you get to the over 65 age group, that's when you get 134 cases, 33 hospitalized. So all of a sudden, a big jump. Yeah. It's like 4, 6, 9, 33. So being over the age of 65, you should get a high-dose flu vaccine. It's a different vaccine. And 4 people. The 4 deaths that we have were all in that age group.
Okay, so I got 14 years before I need to take a flu shot. All right, got it.
Get your flu shot.
I've never done one.
That's like saying, you know, my favorite way to explain that, just like mathematically speaking, this is a direct correlation. That's like saying I never wear my seatbelt and I never get in a car accident.
Right.
Those two things are unrelated.
Right. But
there's just how well you might do in that car accident is why I wear my seatbelt.
I've noticed amongst my peers that the last 36 years of radio that usually I'd work overnight. So I don't see anybody.
Yeah.
So never get sick because I'm never around anybody. And then if I did days and worked around people, might get sick. But overall, typically not get sick because I'm usually isolated from people in radio. And then when I was working for CBS, we had an outbreak. So
what kind of outbreak?
It was probably,
I hope it's not syphilis.
It was probably flu or something because everybody was getting like the cold or whatever, but we were passing it around to each other through the microphone.
Yeah.
Yeah. So CBS ordered a mandate that we all had to provide our own, we call them mic condoms, but the little foam thing that goes over the mic.
Yeah.
And when you're done with your shift, you take it with you.
Barrier protection.
Yes. And then the next guy comes in and he puts his on the mic. So that way the funk would stay in the foamy thing that goes to the mic condom.
Yeah.
That's the only way I know how to name it.
Yeah.
It goes over that. And because we can't use like Lysol to spray the equipment.
Because the electronics.
Because the electronics. But not only that, it leaves a residue and makes everything sticky.
It depends on how good of a brand you're using, but yes.
So we had to find other ways. And yeah, CBS said that we had to start using
the same things that helped with COVID. When we were telling people those generic things, as like the 6-foot, don't touch your hands to your face or mouth, wash your hands. All of those things are general principles that decrease viral infection. or viral transmission.
Right.
And thus viral infections. So staying distant, not sharing things that are within 6 feet, especially things that are right in your face like a microphone.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're talking about respiratory droplets. And what we don't like to admit as people is that even if you don't see spit coming out of your mouth, when you speak, you are sending little droplets out. That's something that a lot of people didn't understand where within the church thing during COVID is that having fewer people singing on stage
mm-hmm.
was protective. Because when you're singing, you have more droplets.
Right.
Get further because you're
projecting.
Speaking with this force. Yes. And so a lot of people toned down, or it was recommended to try to tone down like worship service because you're just trying to keep people from sending bugs further.
You know, they always put the drummer back behind the plexiglass, you know?
Yeah.
They always put him in a cage. That's so unfair because everybody else gets to be free range. See, so yeah. They should take the choir singers, put them behind plexiglass.
But it's actually like more like emphatic that the people watching as well being separated by a pew.
Put them in plexiglass.
Everyone's in plexiglass. Yeah. And then that might help with some of the less acoustically friendly voices.
Huh?
You're in your own little thing. But no, if you feel sick, just wear a mask again. The cheap disposable mask is fine. A cloth mask is fine. A gaiter, anything. If you're not sure if you're getting sick, just put something over your mouth.
You know, after dealing with COVID and the mask thing and all that, you would think now it would be more socially acceptable to just wear a mask without somebody looking at it. What's wrong with that guy? Because, I mean, even if you just got the cough, you got the sniffles, it may not be COVID.
Arkansans have died in a month.
But it could just be the common cold.
But they're all viruses.
Right. But
they're
just varying degrees. If you just got the common cold, wouldn't it make sense to mask up so that way you don't infect everybody else?
And I'm still in awe at, I know somebody that was at the grocery store, and somebody started talking to her, and that person told her, oh, yeah, one of my children has COVID. You live with someone that has active COVID, you know it,
mm-hmm.
and you're at the grocery store without a mask.
Mm-hmm.
Rude.
Yeah.
Like, that is rude.
I mean, even if I was at the house,
you could do
I'd
a
still
Walmart pickup.
A mask.
You could do a Walmart pickup. They'll put it in your trunk for you. Like, mm-hmm. you don't have to touch anything or anyone or be within 6 feet of anyone. And she's going to walk up to somebody at Walmart and talk to them and tell them that, oh, one of my kids has COVID.
Oh, thanks.
That's not nice. 584 people have died in Arkansas from COVID this year.
Just this year alone.
And you should not spread it.
Don't be a spreader.
The only shame you should feel, you shouldn't feel shame or guilt about wearing a mask in public. You should feel shame and guilt if you don't wear a mask in public and you don't feel good.
And you're a spreader.
And if you don't feel good, try to stay home. Ask for help. Say, hey, I don't feel good, but I really needed some milk. Would you be able to bring some to my house?
Employers have been more forgiving since COVID about not feeling good. Because it used to be if you didn't feel good, it's like, whatever,
you better come
to work anyways. And then, you know, you infect everybody else. And then half the work crew is gone because they're out sick.
Right. And if there's any chance that you can wear a mask and follow those same kind of procedures. While if you're not sure if you're going to get sick. So say if you've had an exposure and you know, you can go ahead and wear a mask and give it a few days, 3 to 5 days. You're probably going to get symptoms within that time frame. So if you know that you had somebody at home that had COVID, but you feel fine,
mm-hmm.
right? Wear a mask. Because by the time you have symptoms, you are already shedding the virus in your spit dribbles.
Ugh.
And those spit dribbles, you don't always see those. And you can think, I don't spit when I talk. And it's like, well, humans do that. So our mouths are wet.
You know that saying, say it, don't spray it?
You always spray it. Just some things you can't are so small you can't see.
Yeah.
And those large ones that you can see are actually less likely to get you sick. There's a certain size of spit droplets that are more likely to make you sick. Because if they're too big, gravity pulls them down and they don't get as far.
Right. It's the light, fluffy
ones. And it's the little tiny ones. They don't get far enough because they don't have enough weight to get far enough.
But then the wind will pick them up.
It's the medium-sized droplets. So it's not the teeny tiniest ones. It's not the biggest ones. It's the medium-sized droplets. And I don't know who's measuring what kind of spit dribbles come out of people's mouths, but that's a unique job.
Look, each spit dribble.
What do you want to be when you grow up? I want to measure spit droplets that come out of people's mouths.
Spit droplet is as unique as a fingerprint.
This is a medium-sized spit droplet.
All right, we got to wrap this thing up. So if anybody wants to get a hold of you, what can they do?
They can call our office at 870-800-9002. If you get the machine, just leave a message. We'll call you back. If you're concerned about your health in an urgent situation, you can always go to the ER. You can also message us on the Facebook. I don't recommend putting your personal information on there, but if you're our patient, and sometimes our message, our patient will message, we'll just call from the office phone when we see that. And if you have the, if you are a patient, you can always message through your app.
Oh, you got an app now. Mm-hmm. Ooh,
yeah, it's nice.
That's cool.
You can ask for refills through it.
Really?
Any message. We're only a responder in the day, but those times that it's like 7 o'clock at your night and you're like, oh, I forgot to ask the doctor about this thing, you can just message.
High-tech doctor in a small town.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
So.
All right. All right, well, the roundtable is brought to you by St. John's Place, Fort Dyess, Wachita Nursing and Rehab in Camden. It's first choice of all your rehabilitation long-term care needs. They provide award-winning short-term therapy services as well. Reach St. John's Place by calling 870-352-2104 or online at stjohnsplaceofarkansas.com and Wachita Nursing and Rehab by calling 870-836-4111 or online at wachitanursing.com. And, of course, First Choice Family Care, 476 Hospital Drive here in Camden, 870-800-9002. Open 7 to 7 for all your medical needs. And Dr. Smith and her staff can make sure that make sure that every patient feels at home. And they have just one goal in mind, and that's a healthier you and hopefully less spit. So go to myfirstchoicecare.com for a new patient packet and then call 870-800-9006. OCMC's Chemical Dependency Unit, they like to remind you that you are not alone. Addiction is a tough thing to get past. And once you make the choice to be a better you, call 870-836-1289 or 800-232-1289. All calls are confidential. And Mitch Lowe's Body Shop, auto body collision repair, framework, glass work, and refinishing. Accidents happen, so you put it in ditch. Better call Maria over there at 837-2560. She'll probably be the one who answers the phone. Everybody's Antiques in El Dorado, corner of Bradley and Hillsboro, have 120 booths and 31,000 square feet to explore. Shop them online at everybodysantiques.com or call 870-875-1444. And Stories Floor and Carpet, 2004 Lorraine in El Dorado. They do more than just flooring. They do custom tile, backsplash, countertops, bathrooms, and more. And you're invited to visualize your new flooring project online at storiesfloor.com. Upload your photo into their visualizer and see your options. 870-862-9446.